Hi everyone, welcome to another interesting topic, oral defense mechanism. Oral cavity is the main entry point for various pathogens to enter into the body. Once the injury has been noted by the host cells, there will be more amount of the protective factors that will be secreted by various lines of the oral cavity, and it will diminish the invasion of the microbe and later helps in healing of the tissues promptly. So, yes, there is a relation between the defense mechanism and the oral cavity. That is, the oral cavity has few defense mechanisms against various pathogens. Homeostasis is nothing but a balance. So, there should always be a balance between the living and also the functional organism. So, there should be a balance between the host, microbes and the environment of the body. Non-specific protection mechanism. The first one being the bacterial balance, that is interference in binding, competition for the nutrients, and the byproducts of one pathogen will be toxic to the other pathogen. So, by all these mechanisms, there exists a balance between various species of the microbes in the body. Then comes the surface integrity, which is nothing but the continuous renewal and desquamation of the epithelial cells to maintain the surface integrity of the epithelium. Then comes the surface fluids and the enzymes, that is any vital tissue will have a fluid over it, that will be flowing over it. So, that fluid contains enzyme which can attach to the foreign objects and eliminates it from the body. Then comes the phagocytic cells, which are nothing but the polymorphonuclear leukocytes and the macrophages, which help in the phagocytosis of the foreign bodies and thus eliminating it from the body. The complement system, which enhances the phagocytosis by immobilizing the bacteria or the toxin. So, it makes sure that the entire foreign body has been eliminated from the body. Then comes the specific protection mechanism, which is nothing but the involvement of humoral and cell mediated immunity. Humoral immunity is mediated by the proliferation of B lymphocyte, which recognize an antigen with the help of the surface receptor, which leads to formation of B cell proliferation, concomitantly plasma cell formation and the immunoglobulins. Finally, the immunoglobulins will neutralize and dispose antigens and toxins from the body. The second one being cell mediated, which is mediated by T lymphocytes, which will capture the already active microbes present in the body, and then it will release a chemical substance called lymphokines that will either inhibit or activate the macrophages, leading to phagocytosis. So, the defense mechanism of oral cavity starts from the saliva, gingival crevicular fluid or otherwise called a circular fluid, and the epithelium of the oral cavity. First being the saliva. We have three major salivary glands, the parotid, submandibular and sublingual, along with various minor salivary glands. The composition of saliva includes 99.5% of water with 0.5% of other substances such as enzymes, inorganic, organic, immunoglobulins, blood group antigens, agglutinins, coagulation factors, various factors. The antibacterial factors includes bicarbonate, sodium, potassium, carbon dioxide, and along with that there are major organic antibacterial factors, that is lysozyme, lactoferrin, myeloperoxidase, lactoperoxidase and agglutinins. Moving to enzyme, amylase, which is first enzyme secreted by the parotid that binds to streptococci and inhibits adhesion and further enhances bacterial clearance. There will be the increased concentration of enzyme in case of periodontal diseases. And there are proteolytic enzymes which will be secreted by the host as well as the bacteria. So, those were the contributors to initiation and progression of periodontal disease. Moving to lysozyme. Lysozyme is an hydrolytic enzyme which cleaves linkage between glycopeptide muramic acid containing region of cell wall. That is, it leads to cell lysis mainly in the veilonella and actinobacillus actinomycetum comitans. So, it will enhance the bacterial autolysin, but it will inhibit its adherence. Then comes the lactoferrin. Lactoferrin links to free ion present in the oral cavity. So, there are few pathogens which requires this ion for the survival. So, it will be either bactericidal or bacteriostatic to those pathogens. It will also be fungicidal, antiviral, anti-inflammatory and immunomodulatory. Peroxidases, that is, few pathogens needs lysine and glutamic acid for their growth. So, these peroxidases will be bactericidal, preventing accumulation of lysine and the glutamic acid, which catalyzes the oxidation of thiocyanate by hydrogen peroxide. Oxidized form of thiocyanates were formed, which were the most toxic against various pathogens such as lactobacillus, streptococcus and actinobacillus. Myeloperoxidase also produce toxic oxidized halide derivatives, which have a protective role against oxygen free radicals. Rather than being alone, it combines with immunoglobulins to have an enhanced antimicrobial activity. The one such combination is the IgA and peroxidase, which has the most enhanced antimicrobial action. Agglutinins. Salivary agglutinins are nothing but gathering up of unattached bacteria to fasten their clearance. In parotid, it will be calcium dependent, and in case of submandibular and sublingual, it is calcium independent. Statherins. Statherins inhibit spontaneous precipitation of calcium phosphate salts. Thus, it inhibits growth of hydroxyapatite crystals and thus preventing formation of something called calcific deposits, that is calculus, thus preventing further progression of periodontal disease. Histatins, nothing but that neutralize the lipopolysaccharide of gram-negative bacteria. It is potent inhibitor of Candida albicans and it also inhibits hemagglutination of P. gingivalis. Cystatins are nothing but cysteine containing phosphoproteins. They are also called as protease inhibitors, that is, it inhibits or protects tissues from proteolytic attacks by bacteria or virus. It regulates the activity of cathepsins during inflammation and it also controls cellular proliferation. Then comes defenses. Defenses were recently found in gingiva, tongue, salivary gland and mucosa, which is a subfamily of antimicrobial peptides. It is also present in oral inflammatory conditions and in oral carcinoma. Salivary antibodies, which are nothing but the immunoglobulins, IgA being the most important salivary immunoglobulin, which will inhibit the bacterial adherence. The others were IgG and IgM. Along with this, peroxidases, which I actually already mentioned, they both have an enhanced antibacterial activity. Salivary buffers and coagulation factor. That is, the maintenance of physiologic hydrogen ion concentration in the oral cavity is brought by bicarbonate carbonic acid system. And it also has various coagulation factors, that is, it will fasten the coagulation and prevents the bacterial invasion and the proliferation or the colonization. Also, the saliva contains fibrinolytic enzymes as well. Then comes the salivary antioxidants, which are nothing but anti-carcinogenic, that is, it inhibits the initiation and progression of oral carcinoma. It fights against reactive oxygen species and reactive nitrogen species, which are the byproducts of smoking, alcoholic beverages, food and dental restorations. Uric acid molecule and peroxidase were the most important salivary antioxidants. In recent studies, they have found these salivary antioxidants prevents cigarette-induced DNA damage as well. Moving to leukocytes, saliva contains all forms of leukocytes, which migrates from the lining of the gingival sulcus to reach the oral cavity. So, the neutrophils will be seen in more number in case of gingivitis. And living polymorphonuclear neutrophils in saliva is known as orogranulocytes, which has a phagocytic activity and it prevents plaque from reaching the gingival sulcus. Moving to the salcular fluid or gingival crevicular fluid, it is a serum exudate secreted by the salcular epithelium in the gingival sulcus. So, the concentration increases during inflammation. It can either adapt cellular or humoral immunity to make the pathogens move out. There will be presence of cytokines during inflammation. The crevicular cells, which is nothing but the neutrophils and the leukocytes, respond to chemotactic substances, phagocytose microbes, and generate superoxide radicals. Interleukin alpha and interleukin beta will enhance the attachment of polymorphonuclear neutrophils and monocytes to the endothelial cells, which will produce prostaglandins and thus responsible for the bone resorption. However, we have interferon alpha, which downregulates interleukin beta and inhibits bone resorption in case of periodontitis. Moving to the oral epithelium. Oral mucosa have an epithelial immunologic function which is very special. It actively responds to infection. Again, just like crevicular fluid, it integrates both innate and acquired immune response. The main important factors were the degree of keratinization and the turnover rate. So, there will be differentiation occurring in the oral cavity that will protect the deeper structures from mastication and abrasive nature of foodstuff. Interleukin 1 produced by the keratinocytes will induce the T cells, and interleukin 2 will bind to the responsive T cells and thus leading to the proliferation of the epithelium. So there is another factor which is nothing but epidermal cell derived thyrocyte activating factor, which is subset of keratinocytes. It has a role in contact hypersensitivity, anti-tumor immunity, and graft rejection. So, this shuttle between the epithelium and the regional lymph nodes. Non-keratinocytes includes Langerhans cells, Merkel cells, and melanocytes. The Langerhans cells were present in the suprabasal layer. They present antigen to the T lymphocytes, either locally or at a lymph node. So, they are otherwise called as modified macrophages or antigen processing cells. So, this is very important, that is the oral mucosa interacts with the anterior lymphoid system in concern with the Langerhans cells to help mount an immune response. So, Langerhans cells is so much important. Waldeyer's ring. Waldeyer's ring is nothing but the lymphoid aggregates which is present in the oropharynx region to prevent the entry of microbes beyond that. So, it includes pharyngeal tonsil, tubal tonsil, palatine tonsil, and lingual tonsil. So, to conclude, though there are various defense mechanisms which is present in the oral cavity, the defense against invasion depends on factors such as integrity of mucous membrane, concentration and quantity of saliva, that is quality and composition of saliva, quantity and composition of gingival crevicular fluid, Waldeyer's ring, blood components towards specific and non-specific immune reactions, and also to the inflammation, specialized host cells to recognize, trap and inactivate foreign microorganisms and cells. All these factors were responsible when there comes a defense. These are my references. Thank you.